It was all a dream on the scene, making memes.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
Hard to wait to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never. We are dream team.
I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Lyric Kane, aka Nini, aka whatever it is that you want to call me. Back with yet another reaction video, as requested in the comment section underneath one of my other videos. Today, I'm going to be checking out Twiztid featuring Caskey and Dominic. I was going to say Dominic, the deep end, but the deep end is actually the name of the song. This is the official music video, I believe. The original video link will be in the description box down below, as well as all of my social media links. Make sure that you follow us on IG, Best Friends Since Birth. Also, check out my music page on IG, Lyric Kane Official. Also, in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Please, please, please make sure you head over there and check out my music. If you like what you hear, then go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. Let's go ahead and get right into it. I'm going to adjust the volume. And have my pen and my paper to take notes with. And let's go ahead. I didn't want to wake up. I was having a much better time asleep. It was almost like a reverse nightmare. Like when you wake up from a nightmare, you're so relieved. I woke up into a nightmare. I'm so glad it's daylight.
The city that rose in the bottomless pit of my soul, becoming half of the better damaged portion of what's cold. Some call it sick, deranged, insane, and sometimes I prefer it rather than just to be labeled as plain or played like some disfigured chess piece in life's corrupted game. Feel the sorrow, life reaching souls, accepting it and still wanting to grow or just let go. But the grips from the fingertips of insanity's overbearing hold feels airtight. If I need the jaws of life to come and cut me out the darkness in an effort to shed light on the subject to the public, the world can live without me, still feel blessed inside to speak my mind and hoping they never doubt me, and through death hoping they remember, and never ever will they ever forget about me. And if I'm resurrected, second coming, a second life, second chance to know about me, the sight beyond sight, close your eyes and still see.
Cause if I see little robots, then I prefer to be shy. Induce me with the pain. Shoot venom in my veins. Cause you don't know my story. No, you don't know my story. There's really nothing for me. So leave me in this quarry. My indiscretions had a warning sign, but I get by, and that's a lie. But I gotta refuse to let them know that on the line in which I ride, I choose to break away. Wanna bring it back to what you take from me, even if it means I gotta go to war with everyone who wanted to end my little bit of everything. Guess I'm too mad or too sad to say. I was born in a city, but now I'm living in a confused state that's full of decay like a toothache. They tried to pull me out, but it was too late. Now I'm a product of a brand new hate. I'd rather die than be what you say. Living a lie to let the truth hang. Individualize me like a new gang. While the rest of y'all just sit there and get played. If we were just the same as the rusty little robots, then I prefer to be shy. Induce me with the pain. Shoot venom in my veins. Cause you don't know.
pretend I'm a tattered rascal, fleeting from the lines, an acid jackal, shackles all on my palms, speak of psychedelic trips gone bad, indeed, recollections of my pissed off dad, sitting in the pathfinder, and I still ain't found shit, but, oh, silhouetted pictures of me with my wrist cut, and I wish you well, hell, I was bullied by the Minotaur, school with a crew, with a toolie inside a rental car, you don't learn from God inside a seminar, but you hear about the devil, air, which way you turn, perhaps you were made to burn in hell, fire. And I desire to be stronger, but the songs that I sing go ever somber in this life of mine. Memoirs of the suicidal. I guess my father is my truest idol.
Cause I'm a silly little robot. Then I prefer to be shy. Induce me with the pain. Shoot venom in my veins. Cause you don't know my story. No, you don't know.
I think those are like comments from the fans. Someone commits suicide every 40 seconds. By 2020, that number is expected to double. Suicide is a serious matter. Per usual, that was definitely intense. Like I mentioned before, I've never heard of horrorcore before this. Horrorcore. Sorry, I keep screwing up the name, y'all. Never heard of Twiztid either. But it's intriguing to me, you know what I mean? To kind of see, I don't know, I feel like I'm low-key witnessing things through someone else's eyes, you know what I mean? It's kind of crazy because, you know, I'm trying to think, because this is technically like a subculture of rap or hip-hop is what I was told. So when you think about rap, like sometimes they talk about death, but it's rarely of their own death or taking their own life. It's usually like gang banging or like shootings or things of that nature. But it's weird because when I hear that type of stuff, I don't know if it's because I'm so used to it that I don't know. I feel like it doesn't affect me. It doesn't reflect me. Like even to the point where I don't even realize what they're saying until like somebody brings it to my attention or I actually like take the time to get to know what the words are, but I'm already bumping it. Whereas maybe with this particular song, maybe because I've seen the visuals with it as well, I don't know. I felt like it really just made me kind of think. It made me want to sit back and literally like try to witness things from the perspectives of the individuals who were kind of telling their stories, or the actors in this case. Crazy, crazy. I can't actually describe the feeling though. It's weird, but in a good way. That right there was definitely pretty cool. The visuals were hella, hella intense. But in a cool way. Very creative way. And at the end, especially to be able to read some of those comments, I'm actually going to go back. Because I was actually thinking as I was watching this, you know, oftentimes in the hip-hop culture, people will go out and commit crimes or they'll commit murders. And it's so easy. I mean, you don't see it as much these days, but back then it was so easy for somebody to scream a rapper's name and be like, well, hip-hop made me do it. So-and-so made me do it. And if I'm correct, and I could be wrong, but I want to say Eminem actually got taken to court a couple of times due to situations like this. And it's just like, bruh, are we serious? So witnessing visuals like this, I wanted to post the questions to the juggalos. And I think juggalettes. I could be wrong. Sorry if I'm screwing that up. But how does horrorcore, as far as like, what end of the stick does horrorcore get with things like that? Like, are they also, have they been blamed for situations like that? Because that's what I was low-key thinking, like, maybe by seeing this, you know, you could be motivating individuals to do it. But then at the end, I'm reading all these comments. Well, I didn't read all of them, but we're going to read them. And people are actually saying, like, your music helps me get through the days. Your music, the reason why I continue to live. One says, my brother passed by overdose that sent me into a very dark hole. Jamie and Paul's music changed my life. All I want to say is thank you. Have impacted my life and who I have become. All in positive ways. Y'all the reason I survive by keeping hope alive. Y'all music lifts me up and helps me with everyday struggles. Helps me not feel alone. I love you motherfuckers. You just don't know. Thanks for all you do. You'd be surprised how much your music's helped me through a lot. That's crazy though, because this, I guess the same way I can look at like certain hip hop songs and find it super relatable, I guess there are individuals who harbor these type of feelings, and it's pretty cool to know that somebody on a larger platform than you, somebody who probably has acquired a popularity that you wish you would have had, or you know what I mean, involved in a music that you wish you could have been talented at, is using this platform and kind of shining light on that situation. That's definitely pretty cool. That's definitely pretty cool. So here's my question also to the Juggalos and the Juggalettes. How did you get turned on to horrorcore? Like I said, I'm 27. I've never heard of horrorcore. This is my first time even realizing there was a subgenre such as this. So how were you introduced to horrorcore? Get down in the comment section down below and let's talk about it. What was the first song you heard? How did it resonate with you to the point where you knew you were going to be a juggler, or it made you a fan and you wanted to continue to listen to it? Also, because I don't hear music like this on the radio, so I'm guessing it would have to be somebody who turned you on to it. Maybe you stumbled upon it. Or how exactly were you introduced to, like, I want to say this subculture. Yeah, this lifestyle. Juggalo seems to definitely be a lifestyle. So let's talk about it down in the comment section down below. Please go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out. Till next time, guys. Peace out. I'm out of here.